YouTubers, and welcome back to another episode here on ESGNet of Madden 17, Pittsburgh Steelers franchise. This is episode 19, and we are in week 19. Take a look right there. Yeah, divisional round, and we're taking on Oakland here, as you see, Jacksonville and New England there on the other side of the bracket there for a chance to play in the divisional round and then possibly play into the AFC Championship game next week. So, first off, we have to take care of Oakland if we want to see either one of those other two teams next week. And this is going to be a very good, close matchup here between these two teams. Of course, we have to deal with Khalil Mack, who is the season sack record holder for the season. Take a look here at our injury report as we go into today's game. There you see, of course, Antonio Brown going to be out for 2 weeks with that broken thumb. And then you see Robert Golden, one of our guys who's been stepping up right before his injury there defensively. And we'll see what we can do here without him. Now, of course, Murray there on the other side for the Oakland Raiders, not going to be in the game. There you see the matchups there from last week there. Of course, that's how Oakland moved on. They beat Cincinnati. There you see Oakland 7-9. They won the AFC West division title and beating the Chiefs there in the tiebreaker. So we'll see. First drive here of the game for Oakland. There you see they dropped the ball. Nice play there from the defense. The defense get a hold of that one, and they get the ball. So we get the ball at the 30-yard line. Give it to Bell here. He's going to run this one, and he's going to take this one down to the 23 on that play. Next play here, 2nd and 3. Bell once again gets his number called, and he's going to take that one up to almost inside the 10-yard line there. That's 2 rushes for 19 yards already, having a great start here. It's 1st and 10, ball in the 11-yard line. Get a little tripped up there that time around, and Bell only gets about a couple of yards on the play. 2nd and 9, Ben Roethlisberger dropping back in the pocket. Ben gets shoved down there on that play. Nice job there from the defense there of the Oakland Raiders. Now, 3rd and 15 here, a big play here. You see Johnson in motion here. You got to try to get the first down here. We'll see what Ben can do. He rifles this one up the middle there. Gives that one to Bryant, and Bryant is in the end zone. Touchdown for the Steelers. First touchdown of the day. Nice job there. Again, that connection between Bryant and Ben Roethlisberger there. You see the replay right there, and yeah, good catch there. Right there with a couple of white shirts near him, but he is able to get the ball and cross the goal line for the touchdown. So nice job there for the Steelers. So now Oakland gets the ball back here on their 2nd drive of the game, and we'll see there Cooper gets the catch, and Cooper does a little spin move here, and he got nothing but green grass there. Open field here. He is taking this one all the way down the field, and that is going to be a touchdown for Oakland. So Oakland getting themselves on the board here. 75-yard touchdown pass there. Nice job. You see Mike Tomlin not liking that at all from his defense. And of course, he's seen that way too often now from his defense here this season. That is one of the big things he has to work on over the offseason. As you see here in the replay, Cooper going down the field here. No problem there for him. And then he's able to tie this ball game back up 7-7. Nice play there from Oakland. So what can Pittsburgh do here? Well, we'll see them at 3rd and 7 here. Ben Roethlisberger dropping back, fires this one up the middle there, and Bryant gets another catch there. That's going to be a nice first down there. Now 2nd and 10, try to get down the field here. Sammy Coates gets this one. He gets a shoestring tackle there, and that's going to be just a yard shy of getting the first down. Now we'll see Williams on the field. He'll get the ball handed to him. He'll go for 8 yards on the play. 1st and 10, ball in the 40-yard line here for Roethlisberger. Roethlisberger throws this one up there, and that's going to be another great catch, this time to Green, the tight end, who gets the first down. Now, big 3rd and 11. We'll see if Ben and the Steelers here can do something. And no one can do anything. Now, he is, I believe that is Wheaton getting covered pretty well there, and he will end up get the ball batted away there from that great defensive play there from the Raiders. And we'll see here that the Pittsburgh Steelers will go for 3, and they will get 3 as Boswell gets that one up the middle. So 2nd and 9 for the Raiders now after the field goal. We'll see what Carr can do as he throws this one. There is a flag on the field here, and again Carr connects with Cooper for a first down. But is this ball going to be coming back? upon the hold call against the Raiders. So that's going to get pushed back to the 16-yard line of the Raiders' side of the field. It's going to be a 2nd and 19 for them. We'll see what they can do here at 2nd and 19. Ball on the 16-yard line here. Carr drops back. He is looking, and he has nobody there as he has to throw that one away. And they put him on his butt there on that play. Now, 3rd and 19, we have another flag here, and it looks like it could be a false start here. Mike Tomlin is hoping that's going to be the call, and yep, it is. Actually, yes, it is a false start. So there will be 3rd and 24. Carr back on his own 11 here. He has plenty of time here to throw the ball. He does so, but has to throw it away. Great job there from the defense. But wait a minute, there is an injury on the field here, and Carr is grabbing his waist there. We find out later on he will be out of the game, so we will not see him for the rest of the game. Ben Roethlisberger there throws this one up the middle there, and there is another flag here. This one could be on the Raiders on the play, and we'll see. Yes, it is a pass interference on the Raiders, and it will be a automatic first down. Alden Smith, the former Missouri Tiger there, we get called on the play. That's going to be a 1st and 10. Now, 2nd and 10, ball on the 45-yard line. Johnson in motion again. Roethlisberger handoff. This is going to be play action here. Roethlisberger drops, looks down the field here, throws that one to Green, and Green will not get the catch. Now we go 3rd and 10. Ball on the, still on the 45-yard line here. Roethlisberger runs here, and he gets taken down as he tries to, try to run that one. He's still looking like he's trying to find someone down the field, but take a look at this one right here. Ben just gets tackled there by Khalil Mack there, who gets the sack there. Nice job as Khalil keeps his eye on the quarterback here and just drops Ben Roethlisberger there for a loss of yardage there. So after the field goal, though, the Raiders will get the ball there inside their own 20. But there you see the backup quarterback throws this one up there, and William Gay gets the interception. Steelers get the ball at midfield. 1st and 10, hand off to Bell. Bell gets some good blocking here. He runs off to the side here. Spins a little spin move and does get the first down marker at the 37-yard line. 1st and 10 for the Steelers. So 2nd and 10 for the Steelers again here. And we'll see Ben Roethlisberger play action. Throws that one to Green, and the big man gets the catch. 1st down. Now 2nd and 10. Ball on the 24-yard line here. Roethlisberger throws this one up there. Nice catch as Brian comes down there. Gets drilled, but he is okay. He will have a little get out of the game for there for a bit. But Ben Roethlisberger throws another one up to, again, Brian, who comes back in the game. Gets that one, and that's going to be a 1st down. Now, or short of a 1st down. It's 3rd and 3. We'll see. Ben has a man in motion here. Changing up the play here as he has Jesse James there moving the play. And we'll see Ben Roethlisberger look, fires, throws that one, and that's going to be an interception. Not what you want to see when you're trying to score, as Lofton gets the catch, and they will be put at the 1-yard line for the Raiders. So the Raiders will have the ball at the 1-yard line. We'll take a look at the replay here. Ben is got a little pressure on that time as he has looked down the field here, but Curtis Lofton comes up. Great job there keeping his eye on the quarterback and throws the ball there into his hands. Now we'll go 3rd and 5 here in the second quarter. With the start of the second quarter here, we'll see the backup come in, and that's going to be a ball that's going to be thrown away as Cook throws that one away and gets pressure. So after the punt, they punt the ball, and the Steelers will get the ball at their own 33. Nice catch, and that's going to be a 1st down for Wheaton. Now 1st and 10, handoff there to Bell, and Bell will get this one, and Bell got his feet moving, and he is moving to the 1st down marker. Move the chains to the 42-yard line here. Ball 1st and 10. And we'll see Bell again moving the chains here on the ground. Nice job there. You see 10 carries for 49 yards. 2nd and 9 now. Play action here for Ben Roethlisberger. Looks, fires, throws that one to Green. Green gets the catch, and he will get marked down at the 26-yard line in Raiders territory. Now, 2nd and 12. Green's in motion here. Looks like we could be possibly seeing him once again get the ball. But we'll see Roethlisberger drops back, fires, throws that one to Bell, who does not get the catch there. The halfback there had a little trouble there holding on to the ball that time around. Now 3rd and 12, Roethlisberger will drop back. He'll look, he'll fire, and they'll throw that one to Brian, who's able to hold on to it and get the 1st down at the 14. Nice job there. You see now over a little 6 receptions, getting close to that 100-yard mark. Now 1st and 10, next play. Bell's trying to run this one. Keeps his feet moving here, as he gets inside the 10-yard line. They'll mark him at the 8. He has now 54 yards here on the game. 3rd and 4, Roethlisberger's getting out of the pocket here, and we've seen what happened last time, but he rifles this one in there, and that is going to be a touchdown. Ben Roethlisberger gets that one in there. Nice job as they are on the board once again, making it now 16-7. Raiders trailing here in the divisional round game. So take a look as you see Coates gets in there, gets the catch, holds onto the ball, gets slammed down there by the Raiders in the end zone, and enough for the touchdown. So 16-17, we'll see here, 3rd and 1 from James there for the Raiders, and he will get tackled there. That is going to be enough for the first down. Handoff once again, or excuse me, this is Jones, not James, but Jones gets this one. But there is a flag on the play here. We'll see who this is on. It will be a 1st and 10 if it holds up for the Raiders, but it is not. And that's going to put them now at 1st and 19, pushing back to their own 27-yard line. And we'll see what's going to happen here between the Raiders defense and the Steelers. Raiders offense and Steelers defense. 1st and 19. We'll see Jones again run this one, and we'll see a matchup. That ball gets dropped right there. Nice hit move right there from the Steelers defense, and they get the ball. Nice play, as that is Jones' 2nd fumble here today. He fumbled one back earlier, and we'll see him again fumble this one. Now, he fumbled the first one, the first drive of the game, and they scored a touchdown. Will they be able to do that again? As you take a look at the replay, just a nice, good, clean hit there to the back. So 12 of 20 now, 138 yards, 2 touchdowns, 1 interception now for Ben Roethlisberger. 1st and 10, ball in the 28-yard line, and we'll see this one getting thrown to Brian as he gets the catch. And there you see Ben Roethlisberger's numbers up there. Now 1st and 10 again, and we'll see Bell. Bell gets the ball on the ground, and he will run this one. And it just could be 2 yards there on that play. 2nd and 8, and Bell once again gets his number called here. Gets enough for the first down and a little bit more. Go ahead and tackling them at the 5. We'll see now 1st and goal, and Bell gets in there. No problem. Gets in the end zone. Nice job, and the Steelers are on the board again now. Bell, of course, got his first rushing touchdown here today, and has now put the score at 23-7. Now 3rd and 10 here for Cook and the Raiders. And nice catch there as Burns, Artie Burns, gets the interception. He boggles the ball around and is able to get the pick 6. And that is going to be enough right there. You see he is excited about it. Take a look here. Great job of just keeping his focus there on the ball, getting the ball and taking it in for a pick 6. Nice play there from the Steelers back there as he puts another point, 6 more points on the board here by way of the defense. Now 1st and 10, after that play, the Raiders will get the ball once again. Cook, fake handoff there. He's trying to run this one and does not and gets stopped in the backfield for a loss of 2. Cook again throws this one up the middle, and that's going to be picked off right there as Thomas gets the catch, and that's going to be an interception right there in Raiders territory as they mark him down at the 26-yard line. A nice play there here, and it's not even, we've still got not even the second half just yet to play. So we'll see that Thomas right there reads the quarterback very well there, sees the ball's going to come towards him and grabs it, and that is going to be a great defensive stop there, and we'll get the Steelers the ball at the 29. So 2nd and 13, I should say, and there you see Bell trying to muscle himself in that tackle, get him out of that tackle there. And we'll see at 3rd and 12, Ben Roethlisberger play action here. He's going to throw this one, but that one gets batted away there. Almost was intercepted there. A little dangerous right that play. But it's going to be a complete pass, so they'll have to be forced to kick a field goal. They'll kick this one at the 28. That's going to be enough for the kick, as that's going to be another 3 points. It's now 33-7 here as we still have 2.5 minutes left in the second quarter. As Cook there, this defensively now, he is now down. But Ryan Shazier comes down and he takes down Cook, but now he's in the pain there. You see he's grabbing his back, and we find out later on that he will be missing rest of the season here. We'll get an injury report on him a little later. 2nd and 15. Ball on the 19-yard line here for Cook and the Raiders as Cook throws this one up there. That's going to be a catch, and they keep the feet in bounds. Referees say yes, and it's going to be a first down. There you see Cooper, third reception of the day, 103 yards for him. First and 10 for Cook and the Raiders. That's going to be a nice screen pass to Jones. Jones this time is able to hold on to it as Harrison comes down for the tackle. Third and 2, and again, Jones gets a catch this time. They're going to go try to throw to him more often now. So now we go first and 10. Cook drops back, looks, has plenty of time here. Before he does, he gets hit as he tries to throw there, and that will be a loss there on that one. Now third and inches for the Raiders, as we'll see Cook dropping back here, able to find a man there, and enough for the first down as they go ahead and move the chains and call for a timeout here as they try to figure out what they need to do here against the Steelers D. First and 10, ball on the 30-yard line here, and we'll see Cook throws this one, and that one again thrown to the halfback there, but we'll see again, they'll call another timeout here as they have less than 45 seconds left here for the end of the first half. Throw again to Jones, and Jones gets pushed out of bounds there. Good idea there for the Raiders as they now dropped at the 16. 40 seconds left here as Cook is looking down the field here, and he gets hit right behind him, and that's going to be a loss there on that play. Now, third and 12, we'll see Cook drop back here. He'll throw another screen pass there to his fullback. The fullback gets this one, and the fullback will run out at the 8-yard line, keeping 7 seconds left here for a chance to get a field goal in and to get another 3 points on the board, making it now 33-10. As we go into the second half of this ball game. As you see, halftime score 33-10 here today against the Raiders. So far, Steelers defense is stepping up here. They've already got 2 interceptions and already scored once, actually twice really, after turnovers. Of course, that fumble at the beginning of the game, and then of course the interception there from William Gay, who took a pick six. So now, going to the third quarter now, we'll see 3rd and 5. Ball on the 33-yard line here for the Raiders, or for the Steelers there, as you see Bell runs this one. Nice run there from him. He has now got, I believe, now 85 yards now, getting just closer to that century mark here today. As we'll see, this one is going to be given to Williams, and Williams gets stopped there on that play. And not much yards on that one. I see pretty much no gain. 3rd and 8 for Roethlisberger. He drops back deep in the pocket. Throws this one up the middle there, and that one's going to get to Sammy Coates. And Coates will drop the ball. He catches it, gets hit. That's going to be a fumble. And there you see Roethlisberger had to tackle down the defender there on that play. As that's going to be considered an interception. Sammy Coates not happy about that at all. He's going to get a good talking to on the sidelines there. We'll see the replay and see how this happened. Now, Coates comes up with it, gets it, and it gets punched out from behind there, and he's not able to hold on to it. So the ball security from him, that was on his fault there. He should have held on to it after the catch, but it got punched out behind him. So the Raiders will get the ball at the 42-yard line here. We'll see now a couple plays later, 3rd and 3, or 3rd and 6 now. We'll see another screen pass there to try to stop the fullback here, and they do so, and the fullback will only get 2 yards on the play. They'll be marked at the 40-yard line. And we'll see now they're going to kick for a field goal here. Should be about a 53, 55. But wait a minute. It's going to be a trick play. And Smith gets the ball. And that is going to be a trick play by the Raiders. But that does not, or does help them there. They do get enough for the first down. They'll keep moving on. Or actually be shy of the first down. So the Steelers will get the ball down at the 41-yard line here. Good try there from the Raiders, but not good enough. But there you see Bryant gets the catch. He will get marked at the 26 there inside Raider territory. Now we'll see Roethlisberger again. Next play gives this one to Whedon. Whedon will get into the end zone. That will be a touchdown as, again, the Steelers' offense really clicking here today. 39-10 is the ball game with, of course, the extra point still pending. And I'm telling you, that trick play did not help the Raiders at all when they were just needed 3 yards on the play. They should have just had the field position there. But, hey, that's on them. We'll see here now with minute 13 left here in the third quarter. It is 40-10. First and 10 for Cook and the Raiders. He's going to throw this one up the middle there. Gives that one to Holmes. Holmes takes this one down till finally the Steelers will get a hold of him. They're at the 34-yard line. Big play there for the Raiders as Holmes gets that one, that 35 yards after the run, after the catch there on that run. Now, Jones here trying to muscle himself through there. Gets stopped. Finally at the 26-yard line. Good run there from him. 14 seconds left here in the third quarter. Raiders still trying to move. Second and one. And we'll see there. Crabtree gets the catch. And Crabtree is continuing to run. Finally, he is taken down and knocked over at the 10 here in the third quarter. So, good run there. For third reception now of the day for Crabtree. First and 10 now for the Raiders. As they switch sides here, we'll see Crabtree in motion. And Jones will get the carry there on that one. And that would be just a short game there, just of one, they say, on that play. Now, third and 8, Cook drops back, fires, throws this one there to Holmes, and Holmes gets shoved out at the 5. Good job there from the defense trying to do stop him. Now, fourth and 5, we'll see Cook here dropping back, has good blocking here, and we'll see that that one gets batted away there. Almost another pick 6 there for the Steelers as they'll go ahead and they'll get the ball back. Steelers will go ahead and run the ball out and run the clock down. The final score, 40-10 is your score as Cook and the Raiders will end up losing this one. They'll go home as the Steelers will move on and see who they'll play next week in the championship game. Now, as for injuries, Ryan Shazier, I think he has a broken collarbone, or it's either collarbone or ribs. I can't really remember. I can't remember if it, we show that footage of his injury or explains his injury or not. But, yeah, he will be out for the rest of the season. So his season's over with, and that's going to hurt us there in the linebacker position there, as he has been just on fire for pretty much the majority of the regular season and somewhat of the first game of this postseason. He's been on fire for us and just definitely doing his work there as our line, one of our big time linebackers. Ben Roethlisberger, 17-27, 239 yards, 3 touchdowns. Cook, 26-39, 212 there, no touchdowns. 3 times he is picked off. And of course, David Carr, that 1 touchdown, 1-for-3, 75 yards on the play. He was knocked out of the game early. 29 carries, 117 yards, 1 touchdown for Le'Veon Bell. As for Jones, 18 carries, 50 yards, and 2 fumbles in the ball game from him in that game. He did have 3 broken tackles, but not as many as Bell did. Bell had 4 broken tackles in the game. There you see your receiving numbers there. Bryant, there you see 8 receptions, 102 yards, 1 touchdown for him for the game. There you see Green, 4 receptions, 56 yards. Not much of an impact in the game for him. And Cooper, 114 yards, 4 receptions there for him. Of course, he had that touchdown also. And there you see Marcus Wheaton, 38 yards, 2 receptions for a touchdown. So a big day for the Steelers there, especially defensively. Great job from all of them as they will move on here. And we'll see how this is all going to play out for us as we go into the next round here, which will be the AFC Championship game. And we'll see who we're playing. Now, remember, the AFC Championship game was between, or the AFC side, the other divisional game, was between the Jaguars and Patriots, I believe. And it looks like we're taking on the Jags. Yeah, we're taking on the Jags. Nice. So the Jags defeated Tom Brady and company. Wow. Huh. Guess cheating doesn't really pay. So we'll see in the next episode. We'll see how the Jags will do here against us in the AFC Championship game. I'm kind of a little scared about this game. They took out Tom Brady and company. I can only imagine what they could do to us. It will be a late game there at Heinz Field next week. And we'll see what we can do against them. They finished the season 10-6, and I believe, if I'm not mistaken, they won the AFC South Division title. So we'll see what we can do against them here coming up in the next episode. And stay tuned for a episode of Steeler Nation I will review what happened this previous week here with this game, with the divisional game with the Raiders, and what was going on around the league. So, thank you guys so much for watching and checking out today's episode here. If you guys enjoy the video, please leave a like. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more Steelers franchise here on Madden 17 here on ESGNnet. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Tumblr. The links are down below in the description. Check us out there for the latest on what's going on here on the channel and what's going on in the world in sports in general. Thank you guys so much. And as always, keep yourselves and each other healthy. And I'll see you guys next time.